Hey everyone, I'm William Prince and I'm here at the Forks for Indigenous Day Live 2018. What does Indigenous Day Live mean to me? Indigenous Day in general. Immediately, I think of the celebration of culture that I'm still learning in my adult life. You know, this gift I have around my neck was a small token a few years ago that's continuing to build my knowledge of things, because I didn't grow up very cultural or traditional, and because of that, I always wondered my place in this. I moved to the reserve when I was young and didn't really fit in, and then found my own with my family, learning about my heritage. And to be a part of that legacy, you know, that's always kind of spoke my Indigenous truth for me. Indigenous Day Live means a ton to me, and on many different levels.
I'm illustrated, I'm from Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, and I'm happy that I get to do this stage in particular, because I get to get this message out with one of my poems, and the poem is called Hush. It talks about the struggle that I went through in foster care and how we're not gonna be quiet anymore. And I find it's important that we get in events like this to raise our voice, to have something to say through music, through poetry. So being a part of Indigenous Day Live, it's amazing. And it's awesome to be a part of a movement that can change the world.
My name is Tiffany Ayalik. I'm one of the three members of Quantum Tangle, and I'm super stoked to be part of the Indigenous Day Live celebrations and to be able to share our music nationally. And in the North especially, there's a lot of obstacle for us to reach, you know, certain audience members. So to be able to be on TV and to share with a really large audience is pretty awesome. What I've seen so far is the celebrations have been really balanced, that they're one part celebration and then one part history lesson, I think, for a lot of people who don't know a lot about Indigenous people. So I think it's a really good opportunity to celebrate, but also to educate.
My name is Grayson Gritt. I'm one of the members of Quantum Tangle. It's our big day, so I think it's nice that we get to give out some energy and some songs in that way.
My name is Kaylee Inukshuk Makai. I'm proud to be Indigenous every day of my life. It wasn't always that way. But there's something really awesome about knowing that people across the country are all celebrating and educating all on the same day together, and that power in the numbers and all of the amazing shows that are happening and the representation, for sure. It's really cool to be a part of that.
What's going on, everyone watching? My name is Skyler. Indigenous Day Live, it's kind of a dream come true situation. I remember watching it back in 2014, 2015, and I was like, I want to be on that stage. I'm going to be on that stage. I had that mindset. It means a lot to me to be able to perform here. It's great.
Hello, my name is Jillian Thompson, and I'm in Sister Says. We have Keith Sinclair on guitar. We have Max Lee on drums.
Trevor Ainsworth on percussion. And we have Robert Thompson on bass.
My brother and I have played here before, but not as Sister Says, and it's just amazing to be part of this, to play in a new community, new territory.
Yeah, Indigenous Day Live, Indigenous Day in general, it's a time for sharing. It's an experience that every year I look forward to it, and to be able to be in Winnipeg during these days has been absolutely a treat that I'll honor forever.
I always feel very fortunate and very privileged to sort of experience a lot of these celebrations and honor them with the music.
I think one of the things that's really special about being in Sister Says and playing Indigenous Days is that we're all friends as well as bandmates. Something really special is happening.
Growing up, for one reason or another, I never felt terribly connected to any part of my heritage. On my father's side, I'm Métis, and on my mother's side, I'm Scottish, and of course, I'm Canadian, but none of those really ever connected with me, and I don't really know why that is. Certain events in the world have just led me to be really proud to be from this country and start to explore sort of more about who I am and the histories of that, and it's really, really neat to be part of it, especially at this time when I'm sort of discovering all these things about myself.
My name is Adrian Sutherland, and I'm from Attawapiskat, Ontario. Being part of the Indigenous music scene, I think it's an opportunity for me to be heard and also include messages that are about First Nation issues. And to be a part of the Indigenous Day Live is such a great honor for me to come here and just be around my people and celebrate.
My name is Nico Soul. Been around for quite a few years as a solo artist up until the past 2.5 years, where I've been working with Trans-Pacific Noise Club. I've performed at Aboriginal Day Live 2 times as a solo artist, but I feel like what's particularly interesting about this project is because we do songs in different languages. And to me, as a Métis person, it's sort of been this testament to the fact that our voices really do carry internationally and have a weight across the world, and that we should really support young people that have big ambitions, whether they're inside the norm, outside the norm, whatever they are, I feel like young artists, young voices in general really matter.
My name is Shani, I'm Mohawk, and I remember years ago learning about Aboriginal Day Live and a music festival that celebrates Indigenous music and wanting to be a part of that. So last year was my first year, it was like one of the openers. So this year to be doing a collaboration with Riume is super exciting. I feel really lucky to be celebrating Indigenous people and Indigenous music, and I'm excited.
My name is Logan Staats. I'm from Six Nations, Ontario, Mohawk Turtle Clan, and I'm a singer-songwriter, storyteller. It's really important for me to be a part of Indigenous Day Live because this festival has been going on for a long time, and I remember the first time I attended, you know, and I seen Buffy St. Marie, and how powerful that was for me as just a young man, you know, a young Indigenous man. You know, it's amazing to be on that stage and given the opportunity to do the same for youth across Turtle Island. The Indigenous music scene today is something I'm extremely proud of and honored to be a little bit a part of. You know, there's a sound that's resonating from reservations right now that can't be rivaled by anything. You know, and you're going to see that all in three different places across Canada. Some of the best artists are gathered to represent this day. This is something that I'm super pumped to be a part of. Hey, I'm Logan Staats, and you're watching Digital Drum.